the vote in favour of having confidence in Boris Johnson as leader was 211 votes, and the vote against was 148 votes.
The moment Boris Johnson survived an attempt by his own party to boot him from office.
He does have confidence.
Johnson fending off the mutiny with a margin of just 63 votes in a party-only secret ballot.
I think this is a very good result for politics and for the country. Just in it just I do. Just in this sense, I think it's a convincing result, a decisive result, and I've got a far bigger mandate from my own parliamentary colleagues, for instance, than I had in 2019.
I think, frankly, it's very bad indeed.
Johnson's prime ministership has been fraught with scandal after it emerged he presided over illegal parties at Number 10 during lockdowns. Parties replete with late-night karaoke, fisticuffs and vomiting.
Today I've received a fixed penalty notice from the Metropolitan Police.
Becoming the first sitting UK PM to be found guilty of breaking the law.
I've got no confidence in him.
It's lie after lie.
Good luck to him.
After lie, after lie.
The PM greeted by this as he arrived at the Queen's Platinum Jubilee event on Friday.
He got booed.
The result is worse than one suffered by Johnson's predecessor, Theresa May, who survived a no-confidence challenge with a bigger margin, only to be forced to resign 6 months later.
I think history tells us that this is the beginning of the end.
So, with more than 40% of his own MPs convinced they're better off without him, is this PM a dead man walking?
I think it's an extremely good, positive, conclusive, decisive result.
After lie, after lie, after cover-up, after cover-up.
Okay then, Latika Bourke is our eyes and ears in the UK. She joins us now, Latika. So is it actually an extremely good, positive, decisive result?
Absolutely not. This is total spin from Boris Johnson and his team. He won by a margin of 63 votes, which sounds a lot in an Australian context, but it's really not a lot in a Conservative leadership contest in the UK because there's so many more MPs. So he really is fighting for his life here. It was not the result they would have hoped for.
He is still the leader, though, at the moment. What is running in his favour, if anything, for him to keep it?
Well, the bizarre scenario is that there's no clear rival here in the UK to take over from Boris Johnson. So we're in this situation where Boris Johnson is being kept in his job simply because everyone else you look at is worse.
What is the mood in the UK right now? Watching from afar, it seems like the place is having a giant party around the Jubilee. COVID's sort of largely finished for them. Yet the politics is really dark and gloomy. How do people feel about Boris?
Look, Boris's own ratings have suffered enormously since it was revealed that there were lots of parties held in Number 10 Downing Street during lockdown. Now, Boris Johnson didn't actually attend most of those parties, but nevertheless, Boris Johnson is responsible for that as the Prime Minister and for what goes on in his own office and house. And so his ratings have suffered hugely. Now, that hasn't yet materialised into ousting him, partly because, as I said before, there's no one there to take over. But also, there's just not enough of a clincher to move against him. The country's in quite a good mood at the moment, apart from politics. And if you walked the streets of central London, as I did on the weekend, you certainly wouldn't have heard the word pandemic, and you probably wouldn't have heard the word Boris Johnson. Although he did go to a couple of Jubilee events and he got booed, which is quite serious because if you're waving the Union Jack on a weekend and lining up to see the royal family, you're probably a target Tory voter.
Latika, he survived the no-confidence vote today, though. Did he have any celebratory drinks and did he keep it on the low key?
BYOBs, you might say. Look, we don't know. He did come out with a very bullish statement after the vote, saying that it was a really great win, that he was happy with the result. Clearly, that's not really the case, we think, privately. And that also that the party is going to unite. I mean, that's definitely not the case. The best way to think about this is what happened with Kevin Rudd and Julia Gillard. Kevin Rudd was always determined to get his job back. It took a couple of goes, and you might remember that there was that funny explosion from Simon Crean halfway through where they botched it. That's probably the case now. And until we get a clear successor emerge, Boris Johnson will stay in that job. But, you know, if you talk to Tory MPs here, they always say he only had two jobs, keep Jeremy Corbyn out and get Brexit done. Those two things are done. So whether there was Partygate scandal or not, I think you probably would have been seeing these rumblings about Boris Johnson's leadership by now, because there was always concerns about how long he would last in the job and whether his own personal chaotic style was up for leadership.
So is there any chance, Latika, that Boris stands down at any point, or does he have to be turfed?
Well, it's not his style, certainly, but also it wasn't Julie Gillard's style. We know that political leaders, particularly prime ministers, don't usually leave their prime ministerial dwellings easily. They do have to be dragged out. But once the rot sets in, it's really, really hard for them to recover that. And I do think Boris Johnson is in that position now.
So, Latika, he won't stand down, but there can't be unity while he's there. However, he's not going anywhere and they can't vote him out. Glowing predictions coming up, glowing forecast for you all. Thanks for your time.
Pleasure.